tell you about one of the big technology success stories in New Zealand, a company by the name of Xero that is creating beautiful accounting software. And just before we talk to Andrew Tokeley from Xero, let's take a look at a video about the company first.
If you look at it from a professional skills and capability set, it's a very broad set of skills that are required to actually bring a product like this to market and support and run it.
We still have that small company feel of, well, this is the right thing to do and we need to do this for our customers, so who has the knowledge? And maybe it's someone who's been here for 4 years and works in customer care that you need to get on the team to figure out what's the right way to build this. And maybe it's, you know, the new guy that just started because comes from an accounting background that specializes in that.
And now I'd like you to meet Andrew Tokeley from Xero. Hi, Andrew.
Hi, how's it going?
It has become a very cool company, probably the coolest and the closest that we have to something like Google, I suppose. And the culture of Xero has become a really exciting place to work too, hasn't it?
Yeah, it's funny because we talk about, our CEO Rod will often talk about Wellington becoming this Silicon Valley of Down Under. And so we totally would love to see Xero-like businesses playing on the global stage, starting out in New Zealand, doing using that as a platform for launching a global product in the way that we have. And there's really no barriers to doing that. You know, it's a global market now. The communication facilitates working anywhere. And I think more companies can and are leveraging that benefit. And it's not such a disadvantage being down here anymore. What we get excited about is building beautiful product. And in fact, more than that, we see what we're doing as creating time for people. So we like to think about our product freeing up time for businesses to do what they want to do. They don't want to be doing accounting. You know, accounting, you know, is inherently a chore in a lot of ways. We've done a lot to make it more beautiful. But we want to free up their time. We want to facilitate them talking to their accountant. We want to change the relationship they have with their accountant from someone who's like a compliance generating annual reports to somebody who can provide business advice to free up time for them to work on their business, which is what they have the passion for, not doing their accounts.
It is interesting to think of accounting being beautiful, isn't it? I mean, you've really done to accounting what Steve Jobs did for Apple.
And very deliberately, you know, from the word go, that was always a byline of what we wanted to do. And we haven't deviated from that at all. And in fact, to the extent that the design team is at the very front of every change that goes on in our marketing site, in our products, they have a huge voice in how we deliver the functions that we put into the products. And so we talk about being a design-led company, and that's really important to make sure that we're thinking about the users up front, we're thinking about the problems we're solving, not the functions we're creating.
So when we think of the opportunities for people to jump into the space, if the design is being led from the front, that must create some really exciting opportunities.
Yeah, I mean, and across the whole company. So there's obviously opportunities in our design capability, so we're always looking for hot talent in that space. But in fact, all areas of our business are growing, and across the entire product space, whether you're a developer, a tester, business analyst, a designer, and even within the development space, you might be a specialist in front-end development. And so that's obviously a big part of making beautiful, functional, dynamic software, is that front-end development aspect is thought through really carefully. So if you're a gun in front-end development, then working at Xero is pretty much as cool as you can get, because we do some amazing things within the software to make it hum the way it does. If you're more of a back-end developer, then there's really good opportunities to work at scale in a way that's not possible with a lot of companies that you might work for. We've got huge volumes of data that we're moving around the place. We've got to make sure that's highly secure for obvious reasons. We've got to make sure that it performs well in terms of the experience that the user has doing things. So all those things make for really interesting engineering challenges.
When you look at the growth of the company in the future, do you see this company just continuing to grow at its current pace?
Well, it certainly hasn't slowed down yet. So when I started 4.5 years ago, we were recruiting as fast as we could. We're still recruiting as fast as we can and are truly only limited by finding the right people fast enough. So we haven't yet reached a point where we have to slow down because we, you know, have enough people. I certainly can see us over the next 12 to 18 months almost doubling our capability in product space. And that's an ambitious goal, to find that many people to be able to do that. But that certainly, we would have no trouble finding work for that that group of people.
And plenty of career development opportunities as well?
Yeah, certainly. So again, like my own career, where I've gone from a very technical focus into more of a leadership management role, we have those types of roles where you can take responsibility for a product or a group of engineers and people working on those products. And we also have created people who want to stay on the technical track, roles for them, so that they can provide technical leadership and thought leadership in those spaces without necessarily having to take on the management roles that a lot of people in this industry aren't keen on doing. So we don't, you know, we appreciate that, and we provide opportunities for both types.
And just finally, Andrew, what excites you most about working for a company like Xero?
Look, I mean, it's pretty special to be working in a unique company from New Zealand. So there's certainly a New Zealand pride going on there. So I love the fact that we're doing something special on a global scale, where our roots are not an inhibitor, where it's not a problem that we're from New Zealand. And in fact, in many ways, it's an advantage. And so to be part of that story, to be, you know, the last company I worked for, I would tell someone I worked for that company, and there'd be a blank look on their face. Now I walk down the plane wearing my Xero t-shirt, and the stewardess is talking to me about, she's making jokes about Xero, and, you know, she knows about Xero, and she's met Rod, and yeah, there's very much a sense of people know what we're doing, and that's nice to be part of.
Andrew, thank you very much for joining us today.
Cool, thank you very much.